Commander, you're needed in the Alliance War Room for a status update.
The Eternal Alliance is stronger than ever, Commander. More worlds sign up every day. Name any planet Valen terrorized, and we're helping them recover. Speaking of which, Zakuul contacted us again. They're asking for more aid.
Cut them off. It's about time Zakuul learned to survive without handouts.
Let's hope they can make do with what we've provided.
You're holding out on me, Theron. What's the status of our mission to Iokath?
I was saving the best for last. Lana should be closing in on the superweapon right about now.
Come in, Lana. How's the radiation sickness treating you?
It's nothing I can't handle. Isn't that right, C6? You heard the droid.
Mm-hmm. Lana equals full of herself.
Enough chatter. Have you located the superweapon, Lana?
According to the intel we received, it should be just up ahead. Stand by. Target located. Commencing scan. Power levels are off the charts, and rising by the second. Incredible.
Contact!
Lana? What's happening?
I've got company.
What's the Republic doing here? The Sith Empire. They must be after the superweapon.
Get Lana back online. Hurry.
Working on it.
Don't worry, I lost them.
Lost who?
The Sith Empire and the Republic. They're on Iokath, and they appear to be fighting for control of the superweapon.
Every meter of Iokath belongs to me, from the smallest bolt to the largest superweapon.
The Republic and Empire know that. They just don't care.
Why would they risk everything over this one superweapon?
According to my scans, it's more powerful than anything we've ever encountered.
More powerful than the Eternal Throne?
Quite possibly. If the Republic or Empire claim it, they would usurp the Eternal Alliance as the dominant power in the galaxy. The fallout would be catastrophic.
Between the Eternal Throne and this superweapon, I could conquer entire star systems before breakfast.
But first, we will need to secure it.
We'll meet you on Iokath, Lana. Head for the fleet spire and start clearing a landing zone.
Understood. I'll see you soon.
Ships of the Eternal Fleet, converge on Iokath immediately and await my orders.
We have a war to win.
Hello, Iokath. You're looking as dangerous as ever.
Something's wrong. The Imperial and Republic fleets aren't attacking each other.
No. Something is scrambling our weapon systems. It's coming from the planet's surface, near the superweapon. The Eternal Fleet's offline, Commander. They can't help us.
Tell the Gemini captains to find a workaround. In the meantime, we'll head to the surface and establish a landing zone.
Good call. If there's any way to help our fleet, we'll find it on Iokath. I'll be around.
Yes, sir.
Achieve peace. Impurities detected. Converge. Destroy.
Lana, we've landed on Iokath.
Perfect timing. Meet me at these coordinates, and watch out for droid sentries.
Clear the area. We need the fleet spire safe before we make camp here.
Understood. May the Force ever serve you.
Section authorized. Identify. Eradicate. Maximum eradication. No survivors. Detected. Conclude testing. Dismantling organic.
Commander, welcome back to Iokath.
I hate it when work keeps us apart.
Commander.
At least the reunions are all the sweeter.
You didn't tell us you had company.
Our trigger-happy friend sent these assassins, so I took them captive.
I told you I'm no assassin. I've come to deliver a message from the Republic.
Alara?
When I'm a captive, I tend to prefer Captain Dawn.
The sharpest knives hide behind friendly faces.
Charming company you're keeping these days.
The last Imperial I took in worked out pretty well. Thought I'd go for two.
And a Sith, no less. You always did enjoy a challenge.
Careful, Commander. You'll slip on the fawning Captain Slobber.
Who are you?
Major Quinn. Advisors of the Empress and loyal servant of the Sith Empire. Like Captain Dawn, I come bearing a message.
Supreme Commander Malcolm wants a word with you, in private.
Empress Asena requests the same. But unlike Malcolm, she's open to a group conference.
I have so many admirers and so little time.
We'll keep this brief.
Thank you for extending the Empire this honor, Commander.
The Republic's glad to see you. And my son, on Iokath.
Keep me out of this, Malcolm.
Enough!
Supreme Commander Malcolm, Empress Asena, your armies have started a war over a superweapon of immeasurable power.
You were strong once, but now you're standing in the shadow of my Eternal Alliance, and you want a weapon to even the odds.
We're taking up arms against the Imps, Commander, not you.
This ought to be rich.
It's no secret the Eternal Empire nearly wiped out the Republic. We're struggling to rebuild and protect ourselves. The superweapon on Iokath is the key to the Republic's survival. And I'll be damned if I'm gonna watch it fall into the Empire's treacherous hands.
I didn't come here to be insulted.
What are you getting at, Malcolm?
Havoc Squad's in your blood. Same goes for me and Captain Dorne. We need you. Join forces with the Republic. Help us defeat the Empire, and we'll share access to the superweapon, and all of Iokath.
Iokath belongs to the Eternal Alliance. Why should I share any part of it with you?
Consider it payment for driving off the Imperial looters.
This is preposterous. The Empire openly supported your Eternal Alliance, while the Republic watched from the sidelines.
You walked away from their corruption once before. Now, you can wipe the slate clean.
Help us crush the Republic threat. Once they fall, our empires can both partake in the spoils of Iokath.
Why should I side with either of you when I can strike out alone and take the superweapon for myself?
Iokath is extremely dangerous. As strong as we are, we won't survive a week if we're fighting both armies for control of the world.
Especially with the Eternal Fleet stuck in the mud.
We can achieve great things, but only if we work together.
Say the word, and my forces will join your offensive.
The choice is yours, Commander. Who shall we side with?
We will ally with the Sith Empire.
A wise choice.
You're a disgrace to Havoc Squad. Dorne, do it!
Forgive me, sir!
She got away.
I know, Alara. Her retreat is temporary.
Commander, the Republic has launched their attack.
Fight back with everything you've got. We're on our way. Lana, Major Quinn, defend the fleet spire while we hold off the Republic.
May the Force serve us all.
I'm glad you share my enthusiasm.
Sidious, impress them with the might of the Empire and the Eternal Alliance. Defenses are holding strong. Republic artillery incoming! Look out!
It's been far too long since I've spilled Republic blood. No offense, Commander. We have secured our base and sent the Republic troops whimpering back to their master.
The closer our relationship, the more impressive the results.
Our combined power will fill Malcolm with terror. If I know the Supreme Commander, he's already plotting the Republic's next move.
Strike teams Aurek and Greg suffered heavy losses. The survivors await your orders.
Messina must be loving this, but her victory belongs to her ally. You served with the Alliance Commander. What's your recommendation?
Given our numbers, she will expect us to employ conventional large unit strategies. We should make a show of doing so while preparing a more unconventional response. A surprise attack. Surgical and precise.
Then we'd better shock the Alliance Commander. Gather your top engineers and rally the troops. I'm coming to Iokath.
What are we looking at?
The Republic has erected a formidable base. Their defenses are impressive, but they lack the supplies needed for a long campaign. If we lay siege to Malcolm's base, we can suffocate the Republic offensive and win the war.
Ilara and Malcolm are ex-Havoc Squad. If we surround their base, they'll come at us guns blazing.
Then we attack swiftly, destroy his base, and leave the Republic in ruins.
It's our best shot, and that's why Malcolm will be expecting it. He'll ambush us the second we enter the base. We'll be trapped inside, running blind, and locked in the Republic's sights.
What's stopping us from making a run on the superweapon?
Several thousand Republic troops.
They'd corner us before we gained access. If we want that superweapon, we have to take the base down first.
Indulge me for a moment. My scouts recently found a weapons factory. It's guarded by a host of Iokath droids and filled to the brim with dangerous toys. What do you say we plunder the factory, then use what we find to annihilate Malcolm's base?
I like how you think, Empress. That's the best plan I've heard all day.
I aim to delight.
Coordinate with Lana and get ready to attack the base. Theron and I will take the weapons factory.
Protocols disengaged.
Time to do some damage.
Athena briefed me on your plan to seize the weapon stockpile. Commander, I've received a transmission. It's heavily encoded, but it appears to be from Scorpio. She says only the gods can give us back full control of the Eternal Fleet. As to what that means, your guess is as good as mine.
Joe would be proud.
I never did anything for you. I'll be around.
Let's have some fun.
Is that what I think it is?
One of Iokath's original creators. Looks like it's been dead for centuries.
And let's hope it stays that way.
Whatever happens here, it was all worth it just to see the look on your face.
Very funny. Now, unless you've got another joke up your sleeve, I'm going to get to work. All right, buddy. Let's see what you know about these weapons.
Iokath's even more impressive in person.
Its technologies will defend the Republic soon enough. We've nearly finished construction, but the schematics are missing key pieces of data.
Time is short, Captain. Find a workaround.
Right away, sir.
We can't fail now. The fate of the Republic rests on our shoulders.
I'd say that's enough firepower to get Malcolm a run for his money.
Download every last file. We need to know how to use these weapons and how to build more of them.
Give me 1 minute. That's odd. Some of these files have already been decrypted and translated into BASIC.
We might have Scorpio to thank.
If she's listening, I wouldn't mind the temperature getting bumped up a few degrees. No? Well, I can't blame a guy for trying. Huh. This place used to be the superweapons control room. Looks like our crispy friend here was the last one to use it. Over a millennia ago.
Now's not the time for a history lesson. Give me something we can use now.
I think this might catch your interest. The superweapon's more dangerous than we thought. It wiped out all life on this planet.
What kind of weapon wipes out an entire species and leaves the droids to tend house?
Maybe a bioweapon? Sentient programming? I'm not sure. Only one thing's for certain. According to this data, it was tested on 4 different planets before Iokath. All successful. Over 10 trillion lives gone. This isn't a weapon. It's the apocalypse.
I could unleash it on any Republic world I want. I could take Coruscant.
That's what scares me. There. Downloaded arsenal blueprints, fusion matrices, everything our army needs to gear up with the latest and greatest Iokath weaponry. Now, let's get out of here before that happens.
For ya.
We've received your intel. I'm dispatching teams to secure the rest of the weaponry.
Meet me at Asena's base. It's about time we take the fight to the Republic.
I'll see you there. And I have something to discuss once you arrive. Lana out.
Commander, we need to talk.
Time's short, Lana. What's on your mind?
I've been thinking. How did the Empire, the Republic, and the Eternal Alliance all find the superweapon within minutes of each other?
The timing's too perfect. Can't be a coincidence.
Exactly. We were acting on intel from an anonymous source, and it turns out so was the Empire.
What's your point?
I cross-referenced both sets of data, and they're identical. I'm confident the Republic received the same intel. Whoever tipped us off wanted everyone to clash over the superweapon. They wanted to start a galactic war.
Who benefits from starting a war? Could it be Malcolm? Or Asena?
We can't rule anyone out. Other top suspects include the Shroud, Darth Jadus, a rogue agent inside the Republic's Strategic Information Service.
Let's not rule out Sith intelligence.
The point is, there are too many suspects to count.
Find me a name.
I'm on it, Commander.
Welcome back, Commander. Meet the Crimson Talon, a joint Imperial Alliance production, outfitted with Iokath weaponry and ready for you to pilot in battle.
If I'd known we were exchanging gifts, I wouldn't have shown up empty-handed.
Bring me Malcolm's head and we'll call it even.
Incoming call.
Supreme Commander Malcolm, have you called to surrender?
Not quite. Consider this a friendly warning. My engineers have discovered a backdoor into the superweapon. Once they've gained access, we will turn the weapon against you and win this war for the Republic.
There's no way you bypass the defenses so quickly.
Denial won't save you.
This isn't a game, Malcolm. If you activate that weapon, thousands will die.
But I'll save millions of Republic lives from your Eternal fleet. I thought you'd do the same, but I see I was wrong. Goodbye, Agent Sean.
Damn it, Malcolm!
We'll conquer your father's army and defeat him. Together.
Let's move out.
The Walker is yours, Commander. Lead our charge. Crush the Republic.
You're gonna miss me when I'm gone.
Thank you.
Where's Malcolm?
Right here. Last chance. Surrender, or I activate the superweapon.
No deal.
Theron, you wouldn't.
It's father-son moments like this that make me glad I never had kids.
You've chosen this tyrant over me? Over the Republic?
Yes, I have.
Don't do it, Malcolm!
I see a radiant city. Bathed in light. Forged by the molten gods.
Malcolm!
The superweapon is glorious. And it belongs to the Republic.
It was only a matter of time before Malcolm snapped.
No, Commander. It's you who are blind. No! The gates are closing!
Sir, your connection to the throne is breaking down. Superweapon controls are failing.
No. I can still see it. I know what I must do. They're coming.
Father!
It's too late, Theron. We can't give up now.
You always put the Republic first. I hated you for that. But now you're gone. And I couldn't save you.
Whatever you need, anything at all, just say the word.
I appreciate that. For now, I think it's best if I stay busy. Malcolm's power flux knocked out the superweapon's defenses. Killed the signal that put our ships in lockdown. The Eternal Fleet's back online.
It's about time.
Commander, I'm detecting massive power spikes at the superweapon facility.
Let me guess, that's bad.
More like catastrophic. The weapon core is charging and no one's at the controls. If you don't deactivate it soon, it may obliterate the entire planet.
Too bad Malcolm checked out before he got to see his plan backfire.
We may join him soon enough. You'll never reach the weapon in time.
Hold on. With the shields down, I can remotely slice into the mainframe from here. Maybe buy you enough time to manually kill the weapon at the source.
Do whatever it takes. In the meantime, tell our forces to take shelter. And Lana, I love you.
I love you too. Come back safely, Commander.
Eternal Fleet, move into position and charge all forward batteries. It's time to knock out a superweapon.
I've reached the superweapon facility. How do I shut it down?
You'll need to interface with the main controls. Look for a throne, take a seat, then hope for the best.
This'll be a piece of cake compared to the Eternal Throne.
Let's hope you're right.
Can you drop the act and point me in the direction of the superweapon?
The six bow to no one. Show me your rage. You burn with fury, immolation, anger, a sacrifice, superior.
I didn't come here to be poked and prodded.
You had no choice. You were lured here. Blinded by duty, distracted by trust. You did not see the blade to your neck. The rage in your shadow, the traitor.
I've let too many people into my inner circle. It was only a matter of time before someone stabbed me in the back.
Suspicion corrodes. The betrayer lured you to Iokath, ignited war, sparked the engines of rage, envy, passion, hate, sorrow. The betrayer now offers you sacrifice prime, fuel for the six gods.
I'm not an offering. I am your destroyer.
Rage.
Ships of the Eternal Fleet! Open fire!
Don't worry, Commander. You're safe.
I found the superweapon. It was a giant droid.
I know. You've been talking in your sleep.
Your dreams are almost as bad as mine. Whatever that droid is, you knocked it out of commission with the Eternal Fleet. Now it's recharging and gearing up for a counterattack.
Which is why we must strike soon. Hesitate too long and the Titan may destroy us all.
Someone betrayed me. They lured me into that death trap and sabotaged the throne. Just like they tricked all of us into fighting a war on Iokath.
The conspiracy cuts deeper than we imagined.
Sounds like an inside job, all right. Only a handful of people could get close enough to sabotage the throne.
Who could have done such a thing?
Seen as an expert strategist. If she took me down, the galaxy would be as good as hers.
I always thought she had a case of throne envy.
Why stop with Asena? If we're tallying suspects, we have to consider Aiko, Vizsla, Satil, and the entire Alliance army.
Not to mention Lana. And hell, even me.
Whoever it is, I want them rooted out. Quickly.
There's only one solution. You must monitor everyone.
Hold on, Minister of Paranoia. You can't invade everyone's privacy to sniff out a single rat.
I can't, but the Commander can. Give the order and I'll begin surveillance of everyone, even Theron and myself. It's the only way to flush out the traitor.
I can't take any more chances. If someone so much as scratches their nose, I want to hear about it.
We'll form a surveillance team. Everyone will be considered a suspect.
Excellent. You're awake and looking stronger than ever, I see. Are you ready to return to the battlefield?
We took down Malcolm and stopped the apocalypse. I'd say we've earned a breather.
Before we celebrate, I have to offer my condolences to Agent Shan. Your father was a bore, but I respected his prowess on the battlefield. I'm sorry for your loss.
What are you doing here, Empress?
I've come to wish the Commander good health and to discuss our continued war efforts. You've dealt a crushing blow to the Republic, but they stubbornly refuse to surrender. Our fight for Iokath rages on.
We can plot our next strategy over a bottle of Zakulin wine.
I don't think that would be appropriate, Commander. Not yet. We must rain destruction on the Republic, day and night, until we soak Iokath with their blood. Only then will we emerge triumphant.
Commander?
Alara.
We'll give you two a moment alone.
Good luck on the battlefield, Commander. Victory will be ours.
You've made your choice. I spent so many years searching for you, trying to bring you back. And now, after all of this time, I wish you'd stayed dead.
Join me, Ilara. Republic, Empire, none of that matters now. I'm gonna make the galaxy a better place for everyone.
Starting with your unstoppable attack fleet and brand new superweapon. There's nothing else to say here. Nothing.
Don't listen to her.
I'll investigate Captain Dawn. I doubt she's our saboteur, but we need to rule her out.
I'll promise you right now, whoever this traitor is, we will find them.
And we'll make them pay.
I know you will. While you start searching, I'm gonna win the war they started.
For the Eternal Alliance.
May the Force serve us all.
Akam Inu Nemuk, Najanaya, Akam Minik Merak. Nikat Agar, Kikabam, Naya Agam, Rakati. Amya Nemke, La Perak Akunere. Yang Perluamka, Lamenaya Kira, Nebuar, Nuilak Apa Jangkamkam, Akanem Nang. Karima Aku, Labo Ramamka, Mamlinika, Nang Naya, Kala Jiwa Nimok. Enka Naya Nuga, Jinim Naya La Perak Kalamkara. Kam inu nemuk, naja naya, nani karameraka akam, jau, anayu lebek, nepa, ke kalam bumik nemgam.
Chechupa gumi ni opi, but malia bedwana. Pampa. Chiota flingala. Chechupa. Ni hoi pat. Wanta humpa. Muli rava fopa jibampa wula. Chunky fagota.
Lapo rama.
Pumpa com gabanotas. Chum. Tuga wata kiku uba kili, wata bonkidonko. Wanta humpa, muli rava fopa jigma. Jonga wika? Chioto flingala.